हैव अ लुक. कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ शेयर फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन. यू हैव सम इन्फॉर्मेशन गिवन हियर. प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स 2,900 मिलियन यूरोज. इक्विटी कैपिटल ऑफ द कंपनी 13,000 मिलियन यूरोज. पार वैल्यू ऑफ शेयर इज 40 यूरो ईच. डेट टू इक्विटी रेशियो ऑफ द कंपनी इज 1:3. डेट टू इक्विटी रेशियो ऑफ द प्रॉक्सी कंपनी इज 1:2. नाउ प्रॉक्सी मीन्स वॉट? सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ कंपनी. सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ कंपनी. दिस इज आर कंपनी एंड दिस इज द डेटा ऑफ आर कंपनी एंड दिस इज द डेटा ऑफ द कंपनी, द अदर कंपनी विच इज सिमिलर टू अस. दैट मीन्स वी कैन यूज द डेटा ऑफ दिस ऑल्सो. सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ कंपनी. ओके, अदर कंपनी. बीटा ऑफ द प्रॉक्सी कंपनी इज गिवन टू यू. नाउ आई विल टेल यू वाई डेट इक्विटी रेशियो ऑफ दिस प्रॉक्सी कंपनी इज गिवन. बिकॉज द बीटा गिवन टू यू इज नॉट ऑफ आर कंपनी, इट इज ऑफ प्रॉक्सी कंपनी. एंड इन ऑर्डर टू कन्वर्ट दिस बीटा ऑफ प्रॉक्सी कंपनी टू आर कंपनी, वी विल हैव टू यूज दिस डेट इक्विटी रेशियो. एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर द गेट एंड अनगेट बीटा, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ टू कन्वर्ट दिस प्रॉक्सी कंपनी बीटा इंटू आर कंपनी बीटा. दिस विल बी. नाउ वन मोर थिंग, टेल मी, प्रॉक्सी कंपनीज बीटा इज गिवन टू यू. डिसाइड वेदर दिस इज गेयर्ड और अनगेयर्ड. इफ दिस इज अ गेयर्ड बीटा, दैट मीन्स प्रॉक्सी कंपनी हैज डेट एंड इक्विटी बोथ इन देयर कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर. इफ द प्रॉक्सी कंपनी हैज डेट एंड इक्विटी बोथ, दिस विल बी गेयर्ड बीटा. इफ द प्रॉक्सी कंपनी हैज ओनली equity capital in that in their capital structure, then this will be ungeared beta. Now tell me, the line before that itself says that the debt and equity ratio of the proxy company, it means that for every 2 rupees of equity in the proxy company, 1 rupee of debt has been issued. So it is clear that this company has debt and equity both, and that's why this beta will be the geared beta. Okay, so I will write it here, beta G. Now what we have to do is, we cannot use this beta because this is not our company's beta. We want to use our company's beta, and in our company also there is a debt and equity. So what is required is, we need a geared beta of our company. What we are going to do, we will convert this geared beta of proxy company to ungeared beta, and this ungeared beta will be used to again calculate the geared beta. So in short, I will say this is used only for proxy company, this is used for proxy company and our company also. Ungeared beta is used for both the companies, and then you will calculate our company's geared beta, because this ungeared beta is of both the companies. Okay, we'll do that calculation later on. Long run growth rate of our company, risk free interest rate, market return. Okay, capital expenditure per share, depreciation per share, and change in working capital. Assume the corporate tax rate is 30% and beta of the debt is 0. What do we have to calculate is, calculate the value of the share. And if you remember, we have already solved one such type of question. The only difference in that question and this question is that we have been given with this proxy data, and we have to use the geared and ungeared concept in this question. Otherwise, the entire question is similar to that question, FCFE, free cash flows to equity, if you remember. Also write down here, it is similar to one of the question. I will tell you which question. Question number 20. See, everything is same except that thing. So question number 20. Cool. Have a look how to solve it. Question number 7-6. What will be the formula? It's very simple, sir. Depending upon the data given, we will use free cash flow to equity, 1 plus growth divided by cost of equity minus growth. Okay, and now one by one we will find out the answers. The growth rate has been given to us, which is 8%. So, a couple of things we can note down straight away. The only two figures that we need to calculate is FCFE and cost of equity. So, this is going to be the first working note. Step one. What is the formula? If you have been through the concept video of geared and ungeared beta is equal to ungeared beta in bracket 1 plus debt equity ratio in bracket 1 minus tax. Okay. We have been given with the geared beta of proxy company, which is 0.12, I suppose. 0.20. Ungeared beta we have to find out. See, if this is of proxy, then the entire data will be of proxy. So debt equity ratio of the proxy is 1 is to 2 and 1 minus 0.30 will be the tax rate. If we solve this, we will get an idea of ungeared beta. 0.70 divided by 2 plus 1, 1.35. 0.20 divided by 1.35 comes to 0.148. This is your ungeared beta. It can be used for proxy company as well as our company. So, step two. Calculate geared beta of our company. Again, the same formula. Geared beta is equal to ungeared beta in bracket 1 plus debt equity ratio 1 minus tax. So we have just said that we can use this beta for both the companies, because ungeared beta means both the companies are financed by equity capital only. And if there is only equity capital, the risk of both the companies, because both the companies are similar, proxy means similar, the risk of both the companies will be same. So that's why we can use it for our company also, 0.148. And the debt equity ratio of our company is 1 by 3. Here you will get the geared beta. One point 233. That's 0.1825. This is one of the answer. See, we already had 0.20 in our question, but this is not our beta. This includes the debt equity risk, but this is not our beta. We converted it into ungeared and used the ungeared again to convert it into geared beta. We wanted geared beta because debt equity ratio is there. Debt and equity both are there in the company. But it was not same. In our company it was 1 is to 3 and in their company it was 1 is to 2 only. And since you can see that the debt is more in this case. For every 2 rupees of equity, debt is 1 rupee. Means half of the equity capital is outsiders' money, and half of the like one third of the equity capital is outsiders' money in this case. So risk of this is higher. 0.20 is higher beta. Our company is not that risky. 0.20. So how much risky our company is? Our company is only 0.1825. It is close to 0.20. Okay, step three. Calculate cost of equity using capital asset pricing model. So cost of equity is equal to risk free rate plus geared beta in bracket market return minus risk free rate. Sir, why we are considering geared beta in CAPM? It's simple, sir. If nothing is given in the question regarding geared and ungeared, we would have used a simple beta in CAPM. In portfolio also, you will learn this only. But if a specific things are given regarding the debt and equity, then the beta has two different parts. Risk means beta when the company has debt in its capital, beta when the company doesn't have debt in its capital. And both the beta are different. So that's why it is very important to consider the relevant beta. And why not we are considering ungeared beta in this question? Sir, it's very simple because we want to calculate the return of the cost of equity of the company, and that company has debt in its capital, 1:3 ratio. If the company has debt, the beta should be geared. If the company doesn't have debt, it should be ungeared beta. How much is the risk-free rate? 8.7%. Plus 0.1825 market return 10.3. Even if you see the data also given in this question is same. So we have arrived at this figure of 8.992%. This is the first calculation, and you can put down 0.0899. We can remove this too. It's already four digits. Okay. Now comes the calculation of free cash flow to equity. Have a look. This is working note 2. And this is very easy, like this is what we have seen in question number 20 also. And there is, I think, no need for the explanation. We can repeat those process. First of all, let's calculate number of share. How many number of shares are there? 13,000 is the total capital of the company, and the par value of each share is 40. So the total number of share will be 325 million in numbers. Now calculate earning per share. Earning per share is the total profit of the company, that is 2,900 million divided by 325 million. So earning per share will be exact same figure, I think, 9231, 8.9231. We have the EPS now. Let's calculate the free cash flow to equity per share. So what is the formula? Take the EPS, add back depreciation, deduct CapEx, deduct change in working capital, and add new debt issued. सो व्हाट इज द ईपीएस? 8.9231 प्लस सी कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर 47, डेप्रिसिएशन 39, एड डेप्रिसिएशन 47 माइनस चेंज इन वर्किंग कैपिटल इज 3.45 प्लस हाउ मच इज द न्यू डेट इशूड? वेरी सिंपल, 1/3 ऑफ 47 माइनस 39, 47 वॉट एवर कैपिटल रिक्वायर्ड, 47 प्लस 3.45 माइनस 39, दिस मच इज द नेट कैपिटल रिक्वायर्ड, दिस इज वॉट वी डिड. वॉट इज दिस? इफ यू रिमेंबर, आई हैड ऑलरेडी गिवन द एक्सप्लेनेशन दैट वाई हाउ वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द न्यू डेट. न्यू डेट, विल राइट डाउन कपल ऑफ थिंग्स, अदरवाइज यू विल से दैट आई हैव नॉट डिस्कस्ड इट. Why we are issuing? It's simple. In order to maintain the debt equity ratio of 1:3. Sorry, yeah, 1:3. 1:3 or 1:4? 1:3. Okay. How much is the debt ratio? 25%. 1 divided by 1 plus 3, that is 25%. So yeah, we need to make a correction. It's not 1 by 3, it's 1 by 4. Or we can say 25% of the total capital required. Simple. If you do not do this, the debt equity ratio cannot be maintained. And this is what we discussed in question number 20 also. So this is one thing which is very secretive, you can say, in this question. So let's find out the final answer. 47 plus 3.45 minus 39 into 25%, that is 2.8625. प्लस 8.9231 प्लस 39 माइनस 47 माइनस 3.45, सो दैट्स 0.3356. एफ सी एफ ई, फ्री कैश फ्लो टू इक्विटी. सिंपल. इट वॉज 20% आई थिंक इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन, 20 और समथिंग. सो 0.3356 इज द फाइनल आंसर. Let's write it here. Point 3624 divided by 0.0099, and the final answer is 36.606060. So 36.61 is the market price, or is the value of equity.
that's it.
Are you getting the concept? It was entirely same. The only interesting part was geared and ungeared beta. And it is very important at the same time to understand how we calculate the new debt and why we do that. We do that in order to maintain the debt equity ratio. If we do not issue new debt, what will happen? The entire capital required will be considered as taken from earning per share. So that will be taken from retained earnings, the retained part, and that will disturb the capital ratio of the balance sheet, and it will no more be 1:3 debt equity ratio. 1:3 is the debt to equity ratio, and the debt ratio in the total company. See, there is a difference between debt equity ratio and debt ratio. This is 1:3 and this is 1:3+1. If there are 3 rupees of equity, how much is the debt? 1. And this is equity only, and this is total capital, equity plus debt. So debt ratio is calculated in the total capital, and debt to equity ratio is calculated as per the equity. So both the ratios are different. Don't consider it as 1/3. It is 25%. 1 rupees of the debt, 3 rupees of the equity, total 4 rupees. And in four rupees, 1 rupee is the debt, 25%. Let's move on to question number 77. 2 to 3 questions are left. What we can do is we can continue it after a break. So let's take a break of around 2-3 minutes and 5 minutes maybe, and we'll come back.